Welcome to this video lecture on filtering data in Excel. Within Excel, you can filter your data. So, if you have structured data, you can turn filtering on from the data ribbon and then use the drop-down arrows next to each column label to filter down data and just select a particular subset of the data in a given column. This is also available when you're using an Excel table. As a matter of fact, the default with Excel tables is to have filtering turned on. You can, if it's been turned off in your worksheet, simply switch over to the data ribbon and turn it back on. Once filtering is on, simply click the drop-down arrow next to a column name to be able to filter the worksheet based on the data in a particular column. When you have your data filtered, you can also use that same drop-down arrow to help sort that data. Another wonderful feature is the fact that you can do filtering based upon multiple columns within the same worksheet. So if you have data for, say, sales, you could sort by categories of sales, and then you could sort out, say, perhaps particular dates of sales to get an idea of what's going on with your sales data in particular areas on particular dates without needing to sort your data or hide columns or rows of data. It's very convenient. Once you have finished working with the filtered data, you will find you have a clear filters option. And again, you can go to the drop-down arrow on the filters button or go to the data ribbon and clear through the data ribbon as well. Within a single column, you can select multiple items to filter on. So if you had sales by day of the week, you could say, I would like to have displayed all of my Saturday and Sunday sales data so that you could see how sales are just on the weekends. And you could pull it up and have just those two items displayed and filtered for your data. There's also a set of criteria options for filtering. Some of the things you can filter by. For text, you can choose to filter only records that match a particular text string, so things that are equal to, things that don't are not equal to, things that begin with something, things that end with something, and so on. Numbers, same type of thing, equal to a particular number, greater than or equal to, less than, between, etc. And then of course dates. You could say just show me today's work, show me last week's, next month's, last quarter, whatever you choose. And you can get fairly complex with those. Once you've arranged data and figured out what's the most useful filtered view, it's sometimes very helpful to create what is known as a slicer within your Excel table. So instead of needing to click on the down arrow and pick which ones you want to filter by, you'll create a set of buttons that will sit out at the side of the data, and you simply then click on the button for the data you would like to see. So if I was filtering by day of the week, I would have a set of buttons for every day of the week that I have data for. And then I would simply click on the one that I would like to see. And if I would like to see more than one, I could use my control key to help me select more than one. When you do create a slicer, you'll notice that you automatically get a slicer tools options ribbon to give you more options and more things to format and set up for your slicers. Here we have some sales data, and this is for the widget company. And we have currently programmable widget sales and complex, option one, etc. And they're sorted. If you look at the filter buttons right here, you can see we're currently being sorted by day of the week. And so next to each header label is a drop-down arrow. This is my filter button. If I go over to the data ribbon, you can see here's where I can turn it on or off. So if I would like to see just, oh, let's see, just Friday sales. I would simply select all to turn all of them off and select Friday. And now you can see I just have my Friday sales displayed. You'll notice something is happening. I get the little filter symbol here on my drop down arrow. And over here, my row numbers are no longer black, they are blue. To clear those, I would simply come back here to my drop-down arrow and say clear filter from day of the week, or I could come up here on the data ribbon and click on the clear button up here. Then my row numbers go back to being black and I have no filters turned on currently. So if I would like to resort my data by sales date, I can simply come over here, do the drop down next to sales date, and select oldest to newest, and now my data is back in date order. Within that, I could go ahead and look at various other things. Maybe I say I would like to see just the option one sales. And again, you can see how that turns it on and off. I'm going to go ahead and clear that out though. Next, I would like to just look at sales for, let's do just January of 2018 sales. So now I'm just seeing the January data. And I want to see only sales for the complex widgets. So here are my January sales for the complex widgets. So I can do that multi-filtering as well, or I could say, well, let me also see the option one widgets in there as well. Very easy to manage different slices of data and look at things from different perspectives this way. All right, I have cleared my filters. Now I'd like to see just sales that were over a particular amount. So I am going to say numbers filter greater than or equal to, and I'm going to say $10,000 is my amount. I want to see how many days did I have sales and for what were they that were over $10,000. And you can now see here are all of my sales, and I have quite a few, but you'll notice something here. They're almost all programmable, it looks like. And when I do pull down on the widget type, you can see that they are all programmable. If I find that very useful, or any particular thing very useful, maybe I would like to see sales by days of the week. I could create a slicer for just that. So I switch over to Table Tools Design Ribbon, and here I have an Insert Slicer button. So I simply click on that. I select which of the fields I would like my slicer to be about. In this case, I'm going to use Day of the Week. Click OK. Okay, so here I have my slicer up. It's sitting right beside my data. And I now have my table tools design, and when I select the slicer, I get slicer tools options. I want to make this color coordinate with my data, so I simply come over here and select the slicer style that matches. I probably also want to make this a little bit different in size. Maybe I want to make it a little narrower. And if I were to scroll out some, you can see that my slicer is bigger than it needs to be, so I'm going to make it a little shorter as well. And here it's a little bit easier now to see that my slicer is being displayed. There I've just click on Monday and you're seeing only Monday sales. If I'd like to also see Wednesday and maybe Friday, and now you can see I have Monday, Wednesday, Friday data. Clear them all out and I'm back to showing everything. And again, you come up to that Table Tools Design Ribbon and you can adjust the look of things and then click on the slicer as itself and you get that Slicer Tools Options ribbon.